In this video, I want to explain to you why Jeff Bezos and Amazon are dominating e-com, and why is it that everybody else in the space seems like they're not dominating, or like they're just like second tier. Like, why is Amazon always coming out on top? Okay, so let me explain to you, or like let me show you this book that I would recommend to you. Okay, this is called The Everything Store right here. So it's basically written by Brad Stone. And basically, it's like it's not a biography of Bezos, but I think you can learn a lot of things from business, and especially in the e-com space, where hey, this guy started from nothing, right? He's like, obviously he came from hedge fund, has engineering background, very, very smart guy, but right, with the same principles of long-term thinking, customer satisfaction and stuff. That is why he's the richest person in the world, and that is why he's also dominating e-com. Okay, so like, what are the things that we can learn from this guy? Because like everything he does is public, right? So why is it that people are successful and a ton of other people are not, right? So these are the things that I basically learned from this book. Okay, so basically the guy is just ruthless. Okay, and ruthless in the sense that he is very, very he if he sees a competitor, like he will just take a knife and you just crush and kill them. Okay, and then he takes that aggression and stuff to customer satisfaction as well. So he's very, very specific, and he really, really hones in on like ensuring that the customer experience is top-notch all the time, is A1 all the time. Okay, and these are like the three principles that basically in the book, right? They say it's what he obsesses over about. Okay, so it's about fast shipping times. Okay, it's about seamless customer experience. Okay, and everyday low prices. Okay, so when Bezos, he was thinking about it, right? Like, what do people want from his store, for example? Okay, he wants everybody to have a very, very good customer experience by shopping at Amazon, from having fast shipping times, right? So your package comes to you, delivers to you on time, and better than you expected. So you have a positive connotation of the store, Amazon, right? Number two, seamless customer experience. Okay, he always says that you actually don't want to be talking to anybody from the team, right? Have you ever shopped on Amazon and asked a question before? You probably have not, because their systems are so good, right? The fact that they're so good is because you don't even need to need their help. Right, the software does everything. The store does everything you need already. Okay, so there's never an issue with the brand and the company itself, right? So if you have never talking to customer support, that probably means you are enjoying yourself at that place, at that business, blah blah blah. Okay, so that's number two. And number three, it's everyday low prices. So how does Bezos achieve like low prices, right? Okay, to be fair, he has like tremendous economies of scale. Okay, but even though when they were burning cash at the time, right, they were taking the minimal savings that they can get from every part of the other business and back into passing savings to the customer. Okay, and by passing savings to the customer, right, that would like basically incentivize people to keep buying from them as well. Okay, so like I said before, fast shipping times, seamless customer experience, pass savings to the customer. Okay, very important fundamental e-commerce principles, but I think we can learn from as well. And then basically heavily investing, reinvesting to improve everything: infrastructure, software, efficiency, people, productivity. Okay, so think about these things for yourself, and hopefully this is helpful to you. Okay.